Good morning to all. This class we will discuss about introduction to metrology. The metrology words derives from that Greek words. It deals with the study of measurement. Embracing both experimental and theoretical determinations at any level of uncertainty in any field of science and technology. So this stamps defined from that different from the International Bureau of Weights and Measures. Metrology is split into three subfields. Each deal with distinct subsets. Scientific metrology, industrial metrology, and legal metrology. In scientific metrology is also known as fundamental metrology. Covers the establishment of units of measure, unit systems and quantity systems. There deals with these are the things. The scientific metrology that sets the standards that are adopted as a definition of digital quantity. So this is that initiate, this is that scratch from that starting of particular units and things. Then industrial metrology. So industrial metrology is also known as applied or most of that industry and conducted experiments in various institutions. These are things that follow that norms and procedures. Is concerned with the application of measurement to manufacturing and other processes and the use of in society, ensuring the suitability of measurement instruments and the calibration of quality control. So these are the things you have to deal. So if you conduct, if you take any test that any instruments before you have to confirm whether that instrument is suitable for the particular process. So they are given some norms. So you have to follow that procedure, then you have to conduct the process. Then only to get that exact results from that particular experiments. Next, legal metrology. So, legal metrology is a branch that looks after the regularity aspects of measurement and measurement instruments. The measurement is the process of experimentally obtaining one or more numerical values that can reasonably be attributed to quantity and property. So, this is that one of the subset of metrology. So, these are the things of the classifications of metrology. So, scientific metrology, industrial metrology and legal metrology. So next we discuss what are the objectives of metrology and measurements. So investigate and eliminate different sources of measuring errors. So how to measure that component or system. So various factors they are involved. So the main aim that thing how to reduce or to remove that error from that conditions. So it will be help. This is that one of the objectives. Calibrate measuring instruments regularly in order to maintain accuracy. So if you want to get that good accuracy, so periodically have to calibrate of the particular instruments. It's a helper to get that good accuracy of that results. To adopt quality control techniques to minimize the rework. So to avoid that rework, so to provide that workers and to cost unwanted into no need to use of that particular process. Ensure cost effective inspection and optimal use of available facilities. Determination of the measuring instrument capabilities and ensure that they are quite sufficient for the respective measurements. So you have to choose how to take that measurements of component or system. So what type of instruments is suitable for that particular thing. So based on that need, have to choose that instruments. To carry out that process capability studies to achieve the better component tolerance. So have to follow that procedures to give that within the limit of that component. So not exceed the limit of that values of the particular components. So next we discuss methods of measurements. What are the methods to available to take that value of the particular components? So direct method, Direct method is a simple method of measurement. So compared to other, so direct is a simple method, which the value of quantity to be measured is obtained directly without any calculations. No need to worry about that calculation. Directly have to keep it that objects in that particular place to take that measure that values. So examples, scales, vernier calipers, micrometers and bevel protractors. That type of instruments have to use to measure that value directly. Most widely used in the productions. In productions, various sectors, manufacturing places, mostly the direct method they are followed. Method is not very accurate, depends upon human insensitiveness in making judgment. This is one of that drawbacks or limitations. So depends that persons, what type of instruments you have to use, the quality, the nature of instruments. So these are things very important. So based on that quality to get that good results. So this is that one of that drawbacks. Next, indirect method. Here, the value of the quantity to be measured of then measuring that other quantity. So if it's need to other, if examples have to measure that angle of the particular component with the support of sign bar, so definitely if you need for that slip cages, so without slip cages not possible have to measure. So additionally have to need some things, accessories for that particular process, which are functionally related to that required value. Angle measurements by the sign bars, already said. So measurements of screw pitch diameter by two wire methods or three wire methods. So here we have to use that calculations and to need that wire and also to need that screw pitch cage. So these are the things have to need to calculate. So these are the indirect methods, so a little bit complicated, so compared to that direct method. So next we discuss that comparative. Here the value of quantity to be measured is compared to that known value, that same quantity. Here we give that dial gauge. So this cage is not give that value of that component. It will be help to compare whether that value is right or not. Before you have to use that slip cages, you have to take that value. Then the use of that component, so keep it that particular location, then you have to take it. So to know whether that value is right compared to that master value, master cage value. So which only deviations from that master cage are determined. This is that compared to that other values. This is that comparative. So next, coincidence method. So it is a very small difference between the value of the quantity to be measured and that reference. With the support of this method to get that accuracy. For example, if you use that vernier caliper, you have to measure that length of the component. And there are two scales that are available, main scale and vernier scale. So initially you have to see that main scale. After that, what of the lines have to coincide with the vernier scale, that values also to add it. So why we use that vernier scale to get that accuracy? So that time we have to closely have to look at that lines, what the lines that will be coincide with that vernier scale, that value to be added. So this is that one type of method, but you have to need that experience, that experimenter to know about that how to handle that instrument, how to connect the experiment, then only to get that good results, accuracy results. Next, deflection method. Here the value of the quantity to be measured is directly indicated by the deflection of the pointer. So like that dial indicator. So have to look at that indicator, how much rotation is going on. Then you go for that comparator. So if you use that any mechanical or electrical comparator, that pointer, it will be gone front and back. So based on the things, you have to find out that value of that particular components. So next, contact method and contactless method. This is that type of methods of measurements. See, in conduct method, measuring tip of the instrument touches that surface to be measured. If you conduct that hardness test, if you conduct to measure that surface roughness of that particular objects, so definitely this is that examples of conduct method. So if you touch on that particular surfaces, then only have to take that value with the support of that instruments. Involve dragging the measurement stylus across the surface with the support of stylus. The stylus to be touched on that surface of that component, have to take that measurements of that particular things. Then that contactless, there is no direct contact with the surface to be measured. So like example, with the support of surface magnifications to optical microscope or scanning electron microscope to visualize that welded joints, with the support of that instruments, you have to check it. That type of instruments, no need to be touch on that body. So without touch, like the contactless, you have to take that measure to take that magnifications of that particular surfaces of the component. Thank you.